Welcome to the video lecture on CO5 of Unit 5 pertaining to Measurements and Instrumentation course. Having completed till the inductive and capacitive transducer, we will take up piezoelectric transducer for today's discussion. In the previous session, answers for the self-assessment is discussed. The construction and working of capacity on inductive transducers are also explained. Okay, I request you to respond to these questions. Do you know how vibrations are measured as electric signal? Do you know how your mobile phone touch screen responds to your touch? Well, I shall wait for a few seconds so that you can come up with answers for yourselves. Yes, if you could answer to these questions with appropriate explanations, then this video lecture may not be needed for you. In case, if you could not find answers with appropriate explanations, then please continue watching this video. Today's presentation, piezoelectric transducer. Shown here is the snapshot of a piezoelectric transducer, where you can see two leads, one is red and other is the black, coming out of two disc-like materials. Maybe one positive terminal and other negative terminal of the output voltage. Output voltage from this material? How? Let's find out. Before that, let's first understand how this word piezoelectricity is derived and what does it means. Piezin means to press. Electrum means amber. Amber is a material that produces charge. Hence, piezoelectricity means press to produce charge. Piezoelectricity, press to produce charge. That sounds funny. Okay. Piezoelectric transducer is an active transducer that converts dynamic force or pressure into voltage or vice versa using piezoelectric effect. Hence, this piezoelectric transducer responds only to dynamic force. That means it will not respond to static force or vibrations. It will respond only to dynamic force, means varying amplitude or frequency. This force is converted into voltage. In this, piezoelectric transducer is active because it does not need any power source. Vice versa, meaning it will also convert vibrations into electric signal. And for that, it uses piezoelectric effect. Let us recollect a piezoelectric effect from our physics understanding. Let me show you a browser which contains some explanations. Yes, piezoelectricity was discovered by two French scientists, Jacques and Pierre Curie, in 1880. They realized that pressure applied to quartz or other crystals creates electric charge. This they call it as piezoelectric effect. They also discovered this inverse piezoelectric effect, wherein this electric signal is converted into mechanical deformations. And application, very well known word, Siri on your smartphone. That means the microphone uses piezoelectric principle. Interesting. Let us come back to our presentation. Yes, these two images shows how piezoelectric transducer is constructed. You can see piezoelectric material here is sandwiched between two electrodes, anode, cathode, two electrodes or two metal plates. When applied, mechanical force generates electric voltage. Fine. But how does this happen? How does this piezoelectric happen in a transducer? We know piezoelectric transducer converts force into electric voltage using piezoelectric effect. Fine, but how it does? It's because of this quartz crystal, which has the unique property of generating electrical polarity when mechanical stress is applied to it along a certain plane. This quartz crystal has the property of generating electrical polarity when mechanical stress is applied. What does this electrical polarity mean? Electrical polarity means positive and negative charges are formed on the opposite sides of the crystal whenever mechanical stress is applied. This is called electrical polarization. Hence, this quartz crystal creates this electrical polarization on its sides whenever mechanical stress is applied. And because of this, one side of the crystal becomes positively charged and the other side of the crystal becomes negatively charged. Okay, now you see a crystal which is unstressed, that means no force is applied, no charges induced. And this crystal, wherein compressive stress is actually a measure of internal forces acting on the crystal. So this is a form of force, compressive. When this force is applied on the crystal, you see positive charges are induced on this side and negative charges are induced on the right side. This is called electrical polarization. Hence, a potential difference appears across the crystal. This is how this crystal is able to convert this mechanical force into electric signal. So electrical polarization, hence potential difference, exists across the sides of the crystal. And when tensile stress is applied, the charges are induced in the other way. You can see this diagram. Fine. And orientation of this piezoelectric material. Orientation of this piezoelectric material may be longitudinal, as in this image, or may be transverse. And this indeed influences the magnitude of the voltage generated. This orientation may also induce the magnitude of the generated output. Okay. Having understood that piezoelectric materials are responsible for this electrical output, let us see some of the available piezoelectric crystals as natural resources. Quartz, Rochelle salt, topaz, tourmaline group minerals, and few organic substances. All these are naturally occurring piezoelectric materials. And there are other artificially manufactured piezoelectric materials. These are man-made: polyvinylidene difluoride, lead zirconate titanate, barium titanate, and etc. And of this, this lead zirconate titanate is widely preferred for applications recently. We'll see why. And some of the requirements for these piezoelectric crystals is that they should have stability in frequency. That means it should have stable frequency, should be able to produce high output, and should be insensitive to the extreme temperature and humidity conditions. But unfortunately, there is no piezoelectric material which has all these properties. Oh, fine. But quartz is a highly stable crystal, but it has only small output levels. Rochelle salt gives highest output, but it is sensitive to environmental condition. This is where this PZT, lead zirconate titanate, is used, as it has high output values and as well as it can withstand extreme temperature conditions. This image shows a circuit diagram of basic application for a piezoelectric transducer, wherein we have this piezoelectric crystal embedded between two metal plates, anode and cathode. And when mechanical force is applied, it generates alternating current. The output of the piezoelectric transducer is always alternating, and this alternating current is converted into DC using this full rectifier circuit. This capacitor used to store the charge and discharge to the LED whenever this switch is closed. So this is a small application where this piezoelectric transducer is used to convert mechanical force into electric output. And website link is also provided here. You can refer for further learning. Let us see the demonstration of this application in this video. Okay, we will open this video. So this is the piezoelectric crystal where force is applied here. You see, tappings are done on the crystal. And for each tapping you see electric output. And one more thing, and there is no LED here as shown in the circuit, but here no LED is used here. We have this transducer and this full wave rectifier circuit. This capacitor stores charge. So when we add capacitor, the charge is stored. For each dynamic force, the output is stored. And here the number of piezoelectric crystal is increased, just to increase the amplitude of the electric output. And here we have the switch and LED. And when the switch is pressed, you see capacitor discharges the LED to our presentation. Applications used in vibration measurement. In seismographs to measure vibration in rockets, sound sensor for microphone, buzzers as piezo buzzers. So these three and fourth applications are actually reverse of each other, wherein in the third application this sound energy is converted into electrical output, whereas here this electric output is converted into sound in buses. So for both applications this piezoelectric transducer is preferred. It is also used in touch sensor in mobile phone. So what we see in our mobile phone is the piezoelectric crystal arrays embedded on the touch screen. So the touch screen of the mobile phone contains array of piezoelectric crystals. So whenever we touch a particular point on the touch screen of the mobile phone, a particular crystal is getting activated, and the processor senses the crystal and analyzes which particular array it belongs to and activates that function. This is how this sensor works. It is also used in ultrasonic imaging in medical applications. Okay, good. So we have come to the end of our presentation. Let us check our understanding. Vibrations can be measured as electric signal in a piezoelectric crystal. Yes, of course it can be measured. Answer is true. Touchscreen in mobile phone uses piezoelectric crystals to sense user inputs. Dash has the property to polarize the ions electrically when mechanical stress is applied. So chill salt, PST, PZT, quartz, and of course all the options are correct. So answer is D. Piezoelectric transducer does not have conducting material in it. Piezoelectric transducer has conducting material. a piezoelectric crystal is not conducting, but the transducer has a conducting material. So the answer is false. Can sound waves be converted into electric signal using piezoelectric crystals? Of course, the answer is yes. State the reason, and this is so. So sound waves applied to the piezoelectric transducer, electric output is generated. This is the inverse effect of piezoelectric filter. Good. We have come to our end of the presentation. So that's all for today. Thank you.